Kevin Robinson now on the potential for some pop-ups. Hey, Kev.
Hey, Mike and Sheree, and it's not just Ohio farmers. It's any farmers across the Midwest have endured such a really wet late winter now that's carried over into spring, and essentially we're only a few weeks away from the start of summer. Now a wet start to the summer as well, and that's just part of all the flooding issues across the upper Midwest, the middle Mississippi River Valley. And yeah, fortunately, it's been bad here in the Ohio Valley, but not as bad as it's been a little out to our west. But this is not what you want to see on the radar, right? If you're a farmer or anyone else outside tonight, we've got downpours. Get used to this, because this will be the nature of the rain the next couple of days and even into the weekend, really. It's going to be hard to predict exactly when it pops up or when these downpours flare up. And yeah, the timing's just going to be tricky. But here we go tonight. Just all within the hour, we've had some downpours that have flared up across northern Kentucky, back into parts of southeast Indiana, over to around Osgood and Versailles here, a locally heavy downpour across parts of Ripley County. And then from Independence, moving in the direction of Florence, that's moving over towards Oak Brook right now, over towards Huey's Corner, a big downpour right on top of you. It only lasts about 10 minutes, and then it will move on. And then there's another hefty downpour here, even cranking out some lightning now, dropping down 71. This is heading in the direction of parts of Owen, Carroll, and Gallatin counties here, as you can see, between Patriot and Warsaw along the Ohio River. And then this will likely drop down in the direction of Glencoe and probably down towards the racetrack over around Sparta. So through tonight into tomorrow night, this is how I'm kind of breaking it down. Your rain chances will be greatest near and south of the Ohio River. And the farther south one heads, those rain opportunities obviously will increase. They'll be the highest in our southern tier of counties across parts of northern Kentucky, with a chance for a pop-up or stray downpour as far north as, let's say, maybe areas of the north side of the 275 loop. I think once you get up into parts of Franklin, Butler, Warren, and Clinton counties, at least for now, those rain chances are relatively minimum, if at all, but that will change later. So here's your hour-by-hour forecast. Most of us are still dry, aside from those showers that have flared up near and south of the river. It'll be a slow fall from the 70s tonight into the 60s. So get used to these showers. In fact, over the weekend, more of us will see them as they overspread the entire area, as that humidity, while we've seen it drop a little bit this evening, it's going to be present through the weekend. So pretty much tomorrow is a repeat of today, where most of us are dry, except with a higher rain chances south. And then it looks likely that all of us will at least see some rain Saturday, Sunday, and Monday. Now, I know there's a lot of things to do outdoors, graduation parties and such. No one day will be a washout. Just know, though, you could have some disruptions at almost any time. So here's a look at the weather map. Tonight, that stationary front, the dividing line between more comfortable air, by that I mean less humid air to the north, and the really tropical feel that exists from the Ohio River south. What's going to happen over the weekend is this storm center. You see that spin near Little Rock? That is going to slide right up into the Ohio Valley with all of this tropical moisture. This front in the vicinity will help bring all of that out, and that brings more widespread rain chances for everyone. So here we are tonight, 78 degrees at the airport. Some of that drier air has been trying to sneak in, but with that front right on top of us, I don't think overall it's really going to make a difference in how it feels out. So temperatures tonight pretty much in the 70s for everyone. Some of us still in the upper 70s. So here's a look at Futurecast. You'll see we'll keep those showers going near and south of the river through the night tonight. Again, it won't be for everyone. And then tomorrow we'll likely do it all over again. Notice your best chance of seeing widespread rain deeper you go into Kentucky, but then it looks like scattered showers towards evening could creep their way as far north as the metro. So that's why we have the chance in there. And then by the time we get into Saturday, look what happens. Widespread showers and downpours overspread the entire area Saturday, so most of us will see some rain heading into the weekend. Lows tonight between 65 and 70, and then highs tomorrow generally around 80 degrees, maybe a little cooler the farther south you go, with better chances for rain. So 65 tonight as that shower threat continues while you sleep. Again, don't be surprised. You may hear a rumble of thunder. Nothing severe, though. Otherwise, mostly cloudy. And then for tomorrow, it looks like we'll climb to around 80, mostly cloudy with spotty rain and the greatest chances along and south of the river. Here's your day planner. Starting out in the upper 60s, climbing to around 80 by noon. And here's your 7-day forecast. The reason why you see the weather impact icon Saturday, Sunday, and Monday, Mike and Sheree, because that's the greatest likelihood where we'll all see some rain, but no total washouts expected.
All right, Kevin, thanks for the update. An amazing baseball honor for a local high school player.
Yeah, and